I welcome you to this session in the subject of biochemistry, the topic being metabolism of nucleotides. We shall be dealing with the anabolism, that is the formation of the complex nucleotide or this complex biomolecule from simpler starting materials or simpler biomolecules. Nucleotides, as you know, is the combination of pentose sugar, the nitrogen base and the phosphate group. In the beginning, we shall be dealing with the synthesis of the nitrogen base, that is purines and pyrimidines, and step by step we shall go on to how the purine nucleosides and nucleotides are built up, similarly how the pyrimidine nucleosides and nucleotides are built up. The specific learning objectives of this topic. At the end of this learning session, the learner shall be able to discuss in brief the steps in the de novo biosynthesis of purines and pyrimidine nucleotides along with the regulation. The regulation of de novo synthesis of purines and pyrimidines, and also discuss the salvage pathway in purines. There shall be reference to the de novo synthesis and salvage pathway of pyrimidines too, since similar pathway exists in pyrimidines also. To begin with, we shall just have an insight into the sources of carbon and nitrogen atoms of the purine ring. So, which are the purines? The adenine and the guanine. So, what are the sources of the purine ring in the 9-membered ring of the purine? Now, this is a general structure of the purine. So, as you see, the N1 or this N1 is contributed by amino group of aspartate, that is aspartic acid, amino acid. The second carbon atom is contributed by formyl tetrahydrofolic acid. The third nitrogen and the 9th nitrogen is contributed by amide and nitrogen of the glutamine. The 8th carbon is by the methanyl tetrahydrofolic acid. The 4, 5, 7, that is 4th carbon, 5th carbon and the 7th nitrogen by glycine amino acid. And the 6th position carbon is by the respiratory carbon dioxide. Now, as we go through the synthesis of purine ring, we shall see how all these molecules, biomolecules which we've just stated, they contribute, how they step by step contribute to the formation of the purine ring. So as we go through those biochemical equations and the steps, they will give us an idea of how step by step the purine ring is built up with the help of these starting materials. So remember this basic diagram to understand the source. It's a very important diagram wherein the source of carbon and nitrogen atoms in the purine ring is depicted. So when you remember this structure, the reactions of the synthesis of purines will be more apparent, will be easier to understand. So, purine nucleotides are synthesized by two pathways. One is the de novo synthesis, another is the salvage pathway. Now, we start with the de novo synthesis. What is the meaning of the word de novo? De novo means synthesis of a biomolecule from amphibolic intermediates. Now, what do we mean by amphibolic? Amphibolic are products of anabolic as well as catabolic reactions. That means amphibolic starting materials may be the products of either the breakdown or the synthetic pathway. Either of those pathways may contribute to these amphibolic biomolecules. Products of anabolic, that is building up, or catabolic, that is breakdown reactions, may contribute to the formation of amphibolic biomolecules or the starting material for, in this case, purine nucleotides. So the first reaction in the formation of purine nucleotides, this is referred to as the zero step, because it is just the preparatory step wherein the molecule, this molecule, phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate or PRPP is formed. So this is just the starting material for the starting molecule for the formation of purine nucleotides. Now, why it is called just the preparatory step or the zero step is because this PRPP, phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate, is not only the material required for purine nucleotides by de novo synthesis, it is also required in the synthesis of pyrimidine nucleotides, and it is also the requirement in the purine salvage pathway. So this is a step which can bifurcate into other biochemical pathways also. So this step in de novo synthesis of purines is referred to as just the preparatory step. So the starting material is ribose 5-phosphate, and this ribose 5-phosphate is obtained from the hexose monophosphate pathway shunt. Now this ribose 5-phosphate, in the presence of the enzyme phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate synthase or synthetase, is converted to phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate. The coenzyme required is ATP, which is converted to ADP. So this is the preparatory step in de novo synthesis of purine nucleotides. I explained to you what is de novo. De novo is synthesis of a new compound. De novo, synthesis of a new compound from amphibolic intermediates or amphibolic biomolecules. Amphibolic meaning products of both anabolic as well as catabolic reactions, metabolic reactions. Second step. Now, as I just request you, each step just concentrate, and it will be in due course of time, I will be telling you how to remember these steps also. So just concentrate on each step and it will be easier to study. I'll be giving you methods on how to remember this pathway. It is a long pathway, and but I'll be giving you the study tips on how to remember this pathway. For the present, I just request you just go through the reactants and the products. Okay, now the first step in the de novo synthesis of purines, now we have got the phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate. We have got the phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate from the preparatory step. Glutamine amino acid. See, now this is how glutamine is entering the pathway. Glutamine amino acid plus phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate. You know glutamine contributes the N3, right? So glutamine plus phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate give, in the presence of the enzyme, phosphoribosyl amino transferase. And amine group is added to this phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate, and what is formed is glutamine is converted to glutamic acid and pyrophosphate, and the product 5-phosphoribosyl-1-amine, or simply phosphoribosyl amine, is formed. If you can remember it that way, phosphoribosyl amine is formed in the first step of de novo synthesis of purine. So we have the addition of the nitrogen group from glutamine in purine ring. Next, phosphoribosyl amine is converted to glycinamide ribonucleotide. The short form is GAR. Just pay attention to the short forms too, because it helps you study. Glycinamide ribonucleotide. As soon as you see the short form, you should be able to state the long form of it. So GAR stands for glycinamide ribonucleotide. From what is it formed? From phosphoribosyl amine. So phosphoribosyl amine gives you the product glycinamide ribonucleotide. The short form is GAR. In the presence of which enzyme? Glycinamide ribonucleotide synthetase. And it is over here where the glycinamide. Now see, glycinamide ribonucleotide synthetase. So what does it mean? Glycine is being added. ATP is converted to ADP and phosphate. So in the inset on this side, you can see how the slowly the formation of the ring structure is being taken place. First phosphoribosylamine, and then how one of the carbon atoms or the nitrogen atom of the glycine has been introduced. Slowly the ring structure is being built up. That is shown in the inset, okay, of the purine ring. So coming back to the equation, 5-phosphoribosylamine is converted to glycinamide ribonucleotide GAR in the presence of GAR synthetase or glycinamide ribonucleotide synthetase. And the coenzyme required is ATP converted to ADP plus phosphate. Now, in the beginning itself, I tell you, for the formation of this purine nucleotides, ATP molecules are required, and a total of 5 ATPs are required for the formation of the purine nucleotides. So this is the first ATP molecule which is being introduced. Then glycinamide ribonucleotide GAR now is the role of tetrahydrofolic acid. This is the step 3, tetrahydrofolic acid in the form of N5-N10 methanyl tetrahydrofolic acid. Now tetrahydrofolic acid, you all know, it is responsible for the one carbon transfer. So the carbon atom can be introduced, and it itself it is converted to tetrahydrofolic acid. In the presence of the enzyme glycinamide ribonucleotide transformylase, and the product form is, pay attention, formyl glycinamide ribonucleotide. Formyl glycinamide ribonucleotide, FGAR. Formyl, please pay attention, glycinamide, because the next reaction there is another product is formed which is similar to this product, that's why. So pay attention to this product, formyl glycinamide ribonucleotide, formyl FG, glycinamide ribonucleotide. A stands for the amide portion. Okay, now formyl glycinamide ribonucleotide FGAR from the previous step is being converted to, just look at the product, formyl glycinamidine, formyl glycinamidine ribonucleotide. Now what is this product? FGAM, formyl glycinamidine ribonucleotide. So from FGAR, FGAM is formed. Okay, those are the short forms. Of course, you should know the long forms too. Okay, so what is the amino acid glutamine is required? Okay, for this is an amination reaction. So formyl glycinamidine ribonucleotide amino transferase is required as the enzyme, and glutamic acid is liberated. The second ATP is being introduced. So ATP is converted to ADP. So just remember the product, remember the difference in the name, formyl glycinamidine from glycinamide. Okay. Next, formal glycine amidine ribonucleotide, FGAM, it undergoes a cyclization, that is the closure of the ring by the enzyme. It is easy to remember, cyclase. If the ring has to be closed, the cyclic ring has to be, heterocyclic ring has to be closed, enzyme called as cyclase is required. Addition of water is there. ATP is converted to ADP plus phosphate. So the product form is aminoimidazole ribonucleotide. Aminoimidazole ribonucleotide. And the short form is AIR. From aminoimidazole ribonucleotide by the carboxylation. Now this carboxylation does not require ATP or biotin, which are the coenzymes usually required in carboxylation reaction. So this aminoimidazole carboxylase enzyme is required, but the usual coenzymes like ATP and biotin are not required, and what is formed is 5-amino-4-carboxyaminoimidazole ribonucleotide. Now you can remember it as aminocarboxyaminoimidazole ribonucleotide. The short form is ACAIR. Aminocarboxyaminoimidazole ribonucleotide. Aminocarboxyaminoimidazole ribonucleotide. Now, from aminocarboxyaminoimidazole ribonucleotide, by the addition of aspartate and in the presence of the enzyme succinyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide synthetase, the product succinyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide is formed. You can remember it as, instead of saying it as SAICAR, you can say it as SICAR. Okay, so that I'll be telling you how to remember this pathway, so don't worry. And the coenzyme required is ATP converted to ADP plus phosphate. So SICAR is formed, and it is succinyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide. So from ACAR, SICAR is formed. Okay, remember it that way. Succinyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide is converted by succinyl aminoimidazole carboxide ribonucleotide lyase. Now there is a breakdown. Okay, so it is named after the reactant. So succinyl, the enzyme, the succinyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide lyase, by the removal of the fumaric acid or the fumarate, what is formed is aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide. Aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide. If you look at the short form ACAR or AICAR, you can understand what is the product, aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide. The smart ones amongst you may have already understood. If you remember the short forms, you can remember which is the reactant, which is the product, right? So we'll come to that. From aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide, in the presence of aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide transformylase, there is the next carbon transfer reaction, wherein tetrahydrofolic acid is playing a role in the form of N10 formyl tetrahydrofolic acid is converted to tetrahydrofolic acid. The product formyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide is formed. Formyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide, that is FAICAR, FICAR. So aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide is converted to formyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide. So this is how tetrahydrofolic acid is contributing to the carbon atoms 2 and 8 in the structure of purine ring. From formyl amino imidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide, finally our starting material inosinic acid or inosine monophosphate is formed. The story does not end here. We have to go on to the formation of adenosine monophosphate and guanosine monophosphate, right? From inosine monophosphate, the complex reactions end over here, okay? So inosine monophosphate synthase is required for inosinic acid formation or inosine monophosphate. So we have got the structure around the ribose 5 phosphate. All the atoms have come in, all the carbon and the nitrogen atoms have come in, the starting material inosine monophosphate for the further formation of purines is ready finally. So it was a 10 step reaction. Now is the formation of adenosine monophosphate and guanosine monophosphate. So for the formation of adenosine monophosphate, simple reaction from inosine monophosphate, IMP, AMP is formed. The enzyme required is adenylosuccinate synthase, or simply adenylosuccinate and adenylosuccinase is required. It is a two-step reaction. Here both the steps are shown together. Aspartic acid is converted to fumaric acid. Guanosine triphosphate is converted to guanosine diphosphate and phosphate group, and adenosine monophosphate is formed. So you finally got the purine nucleotide with the phosphate group. Then inosinic acid or IMP is converted to guanylic acid or the GMP. There are two steps in this reaction too, wherein inosine monophosphate dehydrogenase is the first enzyme. And what is in the presence of the coenzyme NAD converted to NADH, first xanthinylic acid is formed, that is XMP, xanthosine monophosphate, and finally guanosine monophosphate is formed by amination reaction. Amido transferase is the enzyme. ATP is converted to AMP and pyrophosphate. Now till the formation of IMP, if you've counted how many ATPs are required plus this ATP, in a total about 5 ATPs are required for the formation of purine nucleotides, approximately. So we have obtained from the starting material ribose 5 phosphate, the adenosine monophosphate and guanosine monophosphate. This was the de novo synthesis. Now there is another pathway too, the salvage pathway. Now regarding de novo synthesis, I should have mentioned in the beginning, de novo is the synthesis of a new compound from amphibolic intermediate. That was stated. It is taking place in the organ liver, and the site, exact site, is the cytoplasm. Okay, it is functional in the organ liver, de novo synthesis pathway, and the site is the cytoplasm, okay, of the hepatic cells. Now this is the table which will help you study the de novo synthesis of purine. Now there are three options by which you can study this pathway according to me. Now this is the table. Just concentrate on the third column, the products. Now if you learn the sequence of the products, that is one way of learning the de novo pathway, or you can study it in the terms of the added atoms, the sequence of the added atoms. First the N9, then C4, C5, N7, C8, and so on. Or you can study it in the form of the sequence of the donors, which are the biomolecules donating or contributing to the structure of the purine atom. So the choice is yours, your frame of mind and the ease of your studying. You can choose either of the three. methods to study. For example, this products, I'll help you through this. Products are PRA, phosphoribosylamine, you can remember. Then GAR, glycinamide, ribonucleotide. Then FGAR, formyl glycinamide, ribonucleotide. Then FGAM, formyl glycinamidine, ribonucleotide. Okay, then aminoimidazole ribonucleotide air, and so on. So that is the way you remember, either through the product, that is easier. Okay, or in another easier method is through the added atoms, the sequence of the added atoms in the purine rings. And of course, the donors I just mentioned to you, the donors are glutamine, glycine, tetrahydrofolic acid, glutamine. Then there is a ring closure in the fifth step. Then carbon dioxide is added, respiratory carbon dioxide. Aspartic acid is contributing. Then there is another ring closure. That is the cyclization I am talking about, closure of the heterocyclic ring of purine. Then formyl tetrahydrofolic acid is added next. And finally, there is a complete ring closure for the purine ring synthesis. Now, how is it? Now, these are the descriptive portion on how ribose 5-phosphate is contributing to the de novo synthesis of purine. So, I'll just rush through the slides. Phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate is derived from ribose 5-phosphate, and the first preparatory step is catalyzed by the enzyme phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate synthetase. Okay, it is synthetase. Then pyrimidine and purine de novo synthesis require phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate. I told you phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate is also the starting material for other biochemical pathways like pyrimidine synthesis and salvage pathway for purines. Now it is also an intermediate in the salvage pathway for purines. Now the first step, phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate in de novo synthesis is aminated by the contribution by glutamic acid. And in the presence of the enzyme phosphoribosyl amidotransferase, it is the, I should have mentioned, is the first committed step. Isse kehte hai commitment. First committed step or the rate limiting step, because it can be regulated by allosteric regulations. So it is the first committed. So this is a commitment in biochemistry, okay? First committed or rate limiting step in the formation of inosine monophosphate. It provides the N9 of purine ring. Then the carbon atoms C4, C5 and N7 of glycine is contributed, and the product glycinamide ribonucleotide is formed by the enzyme glycinamide ribonucleotide synthetase. Then there is formation of formyl glycinamide ribonucleotide by the enzyme glycinamide ribonucleotide formyl transferase. There is a transfer of the one carbon atom contributed by N5, N10, methionine tetrahydrofolate. Next, formyl glycinamide ribonucleotide is converted to formyl glycinamidine ribonucleotide, and what is in the presence of the enzyme formyl glycinamidine amidotransferase, the N3 of the purine structure is contributed. Formyl glycinamidine ribonucleotide cyclase enzyme, or the aminoimidazole ribonucleotide cyclase, converts it to the product aminoimidazole ribonucleotide air by the cyclization reaction for the ring closure by the loss of water and ring closure is occurring. Then formation of carboxyaminoimidazole ribonucleotide occurs by addition of carbon dioxide without the usual coenzymes ATP and biotin, and the enzyme is aminoimidazole ribonucleotide carboxylase. Okay, then condensation of aspartate with the carboxyaminoimidazole ribonucleotide to form succinyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide. succinyl, aminoimidazole, carboxamide, ribonucleotide synthetase to form succinyl, aminoimidazole, carboxamide, ribonucleotide. So the synthetase enzyme is giving rise to the product Sicar. You can remember that way. Then by the lyase enzyme, Sicar lyase, the aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide is formed. Okay, from Sicar, Icar is formed. Then the carbon 2 of formyl tetrahydrofolate is contributed by the aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide transformylase enzyme to form formyl aminoimidazole carboxamide ribonucleotide, FAICAR, FICAR. Then ring closure of FICAR occurs, and the finally, in the presence of the enzyme inosine monophosphate synthetase, what is formed? Purine nucleotide inosine monophosphate is formed after 10 steps, first 10 steps of de novo synthesis, along with the, remember, the preparatory step 2, phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate formation step. Both adenosine and guanosine monophosphates are produced from inosine monophosphate by using the nitrogen of aspartate and glutamate respectively. Addition of aspartate to inosine monophosphate forms adenylosuccinate in the presence of adenylosuccinate synthase, and adenosine monophosphate is formed. GTP is required. Then AMP and GMP form from inosine monophosphate utilizing the nitrogen of aspartate and glutamate respectively, and adenosine monophosphate formed is by the removal of fumarate to form adenosine monophosphate. This is just a description of both the steps. Okay. Then from inosine monophosphate, guanosine monophosphate is formed, and the two enzymes required are xanthosine monophosphate dehydrogenase, and the coenzyme required is NAD. And then there is the glutamine contributing to the amination by the enzyme xanthosine monophosphate glutamine amidotransferase, and finally guanosine monophosphate is formed. Now we come to an important aspect. Everything is important. The regulation of de novo synthesis of purines. Regulation of de novo synthesis of purine. How it can be regulated, the pathway. Now the committed step in the de novo synthesis of purine, that is the one catalyzed by amidotransferase enzyme, is inhibited by the products AMP and GMP, which are allosteric modifiers. So adenosine monophosphate and guanosine monophosphate, which are the end products of de novo synthesis, they may inhibit the enzyme amidotransferase, or the committed step, or the rate regulating step in the de novo synthesis of purines. Then adenosine monophosphate and guanosine monophosphate may act on the same enzyme to convert the monomeric unit to dimeric inactive forms. So that is the mode of action. This is the sources of the pyrimidine ring. Just like the purine rings, which was a 9-membered ring, this is a 6-membered ring. Please, though the name pyrimidine, it is longer, the ring contributed is just the six. It's a small structure of a 6-membered ring. Now in that, the nitrogen N1, C2, N3 is the C2 and N3 is contributed by carbamoyl phosphate. The C2 and N3 is contributed by carbamoyl phosphate, whereas the N1, C6, C5 and C4 is contributed from the amino acid, aspartic acid, okay? So just remember, now this will help you study the de novo synthesis of pyrimidine if you remember this basic structure. If you remember that N1, C6, C5 and C4 is contributed by aspartic acid, and C2 and N3 is contributed by carbamoyl phosphate, it is easy to remember the de novo synthesis of pyrimidines. The steps in adenovacin cyperpyrimidine, this is for ease of study. This is a study tip. If you state all the steps together in this format, it is easy to remember the adenovacin cyperpyrimidines. It is much simpler than the adenovacin cyperpurines. Now, step 1 is carbamyl phosphate synthesis. Step 2 is rate limiting step. Step 3 is formation of pyrimidine ring. Step 4 is oxidation. Step 5 is formation of orotidine monophosphate. Step 6 is decarboxylation. Step 7 is synthesis of triphosphate. Step 8 is formation of CTP. Now, the synthesis of triphosphate is nothing but your UTP, which is formed first, that is uridine triphosphate. So let us leave this slide at this juncture. Since this is just an outline of the de novo synthesis, we'll go into the details. But if you remember the slide, after you go through the pathway, it is easy to remember the de novo synthesis of pyrimidines. First step, carbamyl phosphate synthesis. Then there is a rate limiting step. Then formation of pyrimidine ring and oxidation reaction, formation of the first pyrimidine nucleotide orotidine monophosphate, a decarboxylation step, formation of uridine triphosphate, and then finally formation of cytidine triphosphate. Now the first step in the formation of pyrimidine nucleotides, the bicarbonate in the presence of the enzyme carbamyl phosphate synthetase 2. Now you might have heard about carbamyl phosphate synthetase 1, which is in which cycle? We are not in a class, otherwise I would have asked. It is the urea cycle. And over here in the pyrimidine synthesis, it is carbamyl phosphate synthase 2. And it is carbamyl phosphate is formed. Glutamine is converted to glutamate. It's an amination reaction is also takes place. And ATP, two ATPs are converted to two ADPs. Those are the coenzymes required. So the first step is catalyzed by the enzyme carbamoyl phosphate synthetase 2. Then carbamoyl phosphate is converted to carbamoyl aspartate. Aspartate is converted to phosphate and the enzyme is aspartate transcarbamylase. Aspartate, the end product carbamoyl aspartate, is converted to dihydroorotic acid by the enzyme dihydroorotase by the liberation of water. So dihydroorotic acid is formed. Dihydroorotic acid is converted to orotic acid by the enzyme dihydroorotate dehydrogenase. Whenever there is a dehydrogenase, coenzyme NAD is converted to NADH. Orotic acid is converted to orotidine monophosphate or orotidylic acid by the enzyme orotate phosphoribosyl transferase. Orotate phosphoribosyl transferase. Phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate is converted to pyrophosphate. Orotate phosphoribosyl transferase, OPRTase. Orotidine monophosphate or orotidylic acid is converted to uridylic acid or uridine monophosphate, the first pyrimidine formed in the pathway of de novo synthesis. Orotate monophosphate decarboxylase is the enzyme and decarboxylation occurs, removal of carbon dioxide. Uridylic acid or uridine monophosphate is converted to uridine diphosphate by the enzyme uridine monophosphate kinase. ATP is converted to ADP kinase enzyme. Uridine diphosphate is converted to uridine triphosphate. Nucleoside diphosphate kinase is the enzyme. ATP is converted to ADP. Uridine triphosphate, UTP, is converted to cytidine triphosphate. Now for the formation of cytidine triphosphate, you can remember the enzyme required is cytidine triphosphate synthetase. So CTP synthetase is required. Amination is occurring. So glutamine is converted to glutamate and ATP is converted to ADP. So finally, cytidine triphosphate is formed. Disorders of pyrimidine metabolism. The main disorder is orotic aciduria. It is due to the absence of one or both the enzyme, that is either of the enzyme may be absent or both of the enzyme may be absent, orotate phosphoribosyl transferase enzyme or orotate monophosphate decarboxylase. It is an autosomal recessive condition and it is due to the lack of feedback inhibition, and due to that the product formed in the reaction, orotic acid, whenever it is in the stage it is formed, it is excreted as such in the urine. So orotic acid is production is in excess. Orotic aciduria, the clinical features are retarded growth, there is severe anemia, megaloblastic type of anemia, then crystals are excreted in the urine of orotate, and crystalluria, the same crystals may deposit in the kidney tubules, and urinary tract infection may result. The treatment provided is feeding cytidine or uridine. So that is the treatment provided. Synthesis of deoxyribonucleotide. Now either purine ribonucleoside or pyrimidine ribonucleoside, it has to be converted to the deoxy form. So which is the reaction or the major enzyme required is ribonucleotide reductase. Now since it's a reductase enzyme, the coenzyme required is in reduced form, reduced thioredoxine is converted to oxidized thioredoxine. Now there should not be any lack of this reduced thioredoxine. So oxidized thioredoxine is reconverted back to reduced thioredoxine by the enzyme thioredoxine reductase. Over here, the coenzyme required is NADPH, and NADPH is converted to NADP, and the enzyme is thioredoxine reductase. So the important reaction wherein the ribonucleoside diphosphate is converted to deoxyribonucleoside diphosphate is by the enzyme, catalyzed by the enzyme ribonucleotide reductase. Now disorders of pyrimidine metabolism, just the list of it: orotic aciduria type 1, type 1 and type 2. Type 1 is due to the lack of both the enzyme, orotate phosphoribosyl transferase and orotate monophosphate decarboxylase, both together, defective enzyme. And orotic aciduria type 2 is due to the defective enzyme, orotate monophosphate decarboxylase. Orotic aciduria may also occur due to a defect in the enzyme ornithine transcarbamylase. Then a drug-induced orotic aciduria is possible. The drug which induces it is allopurinol. We'll come to that drug in the next topic. Allopurinol, which is causing orotic aciduria, and the enzyme which the drug affects is orotate monophosphate decarboxylase. Then there is beta-aminoisobutyric aciduria, wherein the catabolic end product of pyrimidine, due to the breakdown of pyrimidine, the end product beta-aminoisobutyric acid is formed, which is excreted in the urine. If it is excreted, the condition is known as beta-aminoisobutyric aciduria. The defective enzyme is transaminase enzyme, and it affects the urea cycle also. Now, regulation of the deoxyribonucleotide formation. In each of the formation, especially the deoxycytidine diphosphate and deoxyuridine diphosphate from CDP and UDP respectively, the positive regulator is ADP, and the inhibitor in case of deoxycytidine diphosphate, diphosphate formation is deoxy-ATP, deoxy-GTP and deoxythymine triphosphate. Now, in the case of deoxyuridine diphosphate from uridine diphosphate, the inhibitor is deoxy-ATP and deoxy-GTP, and the positive regulator is ATP. Similarly, in the formation of deoxy-ADP, the inhibitor is deoxy-ATP and adenosine triphosphate, positive regulator is deoxyguanosine triphosphate. And in the formation of GDP to deoxy-GDP, the positive regulator is deoxythymine triphosphate and the inhibitor is deoxy-ATP. So for each reaction, there is a positive regulator and there is an inhibitor too. You can remember it as this table, so it is easy to learn. Now, regulation of de novo synthesis of pyrimidine nucleotides, the first enzyme, carbamoyl phosphate synthase 2, is feedback inhibited by the product, that is uridine triphosphate, and activated by the starting material, that is phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate. When aspartate transcarbamylase is feedback inhibited by cytidine triphosphate and activated by the purine nucleotide adenosine triphosphate. Then orotate monophosphate decarboxylase is inhibited by uridine monophosphate. And then ATP and GTP regulates CTP formation. ATP and GTP regulates CTP formation. Now we come to the next important pathway, that is salvage pathway for purine. What is the meaning of salvage? Salvage meaning properties saved from destruction. Properties saved from destruction. Or property or anything saved from wastage is called as salvage. What does that mean? Any biomolecule, instead of it is being utilized for some important pathway. So in the wherein the wastage is prevented. So salvage pathway, the site is the RBC, the red blood cell, the WBC, and the brain. The lymphocytes, the erythrocytes, and the brain, wherein the de novo pathway does not operate. De novo pathway, if I had mentioned and if you remember, de novo pathway occurs in the liver, organ liver, and in the site is the cytoplasm. So salvage pathway, the site is the RBC, WBC, and the brain. Now it economizes the internal energy, meaning it saves the energy. Means energy is not required a lot in the form of ATP, and it is not required in the form of ATP. Then disorders result due to the absence of the enzymes or salvage pathway. We'll come to that in the next topic, wherein if there is some deficiency of the enzyme of the salvage pathway, then it will lead to disorders related to purines or pyrimidines. Now the steps or the reactions rather in the salvage pathway, the three important reactions wherein the purine is converted to the purine nucleosides, adenine in the presence of the coenzyme phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate, which is converted to pyrophosphate, adenosine phosphoribosyl transferase is the enzyme, and adenosine monophosphate is formed. Hypoxanthine is converted to inosine monophosphate by the enzyme hypoxanthine guanine phosphoribosyl transferase. This enzyme is remembered by the short form HGPRTase. Phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate is converted to pyrophosphate. The same enzyme, HGPRTase, hypoxanthine guanine phosphoribosyl transferase, is required for the conversion of guanine to guanosine monophosphate. Phosphoribosyl pyrophosphate is converted to pyrophosphate. So these are the three important reactions of the salvage pathway. Apart from this, there are other reactions of the salvage pathway, not over. The purine nucleosides may be also converted to purine nucleotides. For example, adenosine, in the presence of adenosine kinase and coenzyme ATP, may be converted to adenosine monophosphate and adenosine diphosphate. Deoxycytidine, in the presence of ATP, in the presence of the enzyme deoxycytidine kinase, is converted to deoxycytidine monophosphate and adenosine diphosphate. Deoxyadenosine, in the presence of ATP, is converted by the enzyme deoxyadenosine kinase to deoxyadenosine monophosphate and adenosine diphosphate. Deoxyguanosine, in the presence of ATP, is converted by the enzyme deoxyguanosine kinase. All the kinases require ATP, you can remember that way. And it forms deoxyguanosine monophosphate and adenosine diphosphate. So this is synthesis of purine nucleotides by the salvage pathway from purine nucleosides. Now the formation of purine nucleotide triphosphate, So if nucleoside monophosphate of a purine base is available, what happens is the enzyme which may react catalyzes nucleoside monophosphate kinase in the presence of ATP kinase. So ATP converted to ADP, nucleotide diphosphate is formed. ATP converted to ADP in the presence of kinase enzyme, nucleoside diphosphate kinase, same enzyme, nucleotide triphosphate is formed. So here we are talking about purine nucleotide triphosphate formation. So this comes, I bring you to the end of the session on metabolism of nucleotides, the anabolism. And please read up, this is just an outline, so please read up from the prescribed textbook. For further information, you can refer to one textbook or more for further information on this topic. Thank you so much for your attentive and close hearing from the beginning to the end. Thank you so much.